How's it going, guys, and welcome back to our hardcore let's play of our Saboteur build. And I do apologize for the absence. I was on vacation, so I'm sorry about that, but I am back and let's really do some damage here. Okay, I don't want to go too safe, but I don't want to die. I haven't played in a while. Man, you gotta love how this makes so much damage now. Now, I did say before that I was gonna go range. However, what kind of shield do I have though? Okay, yeah, I still have the flame breaker, so I do have this two-handed. Let's see how much damage that does. I can always use that, like, at just in case scenario. I mean, look at that. I can switch in between. That's a good idea. Holy shit! That's a lot of mobs, guys. Let's do this. Ooh, yeah. Let's not die. Okay, electricity. Holy smokes, that's a lot, man. No. Oh yeah, okay, that was doing some more damage now. There's still one guy left. Okay. I ain't gonna die from you. Is that any good? Nope. And that's the basis of the build, it's just fucking running around like a moron. I wonder how much damage we'll do to Hen. Die, fucker. Oh yeah, I got it. It's like this guy. Rest in peace, scum. Yeah, no crap, no kidding. This two-hand man is really good. Okay. So I was thinking about our next kind of build that we can do. Be great if anybody would have any suggestions. Whoa, that's weird. Small lat there, right? Holy shit, see how far it went. The build is, I mean, it has good burst DPS. However, I find that just attacking with a one hand is so bad. If I can get a really good rifle, that would probably help. Thank you. So, we need to report back to the... Let's just report back real quick. You see here that I have the use strange key to enter the depraved sanctuary, which will we will not be doing for the moment because depraved is a bit too high for us right now. You have a plan, blah blah blah. Yeah, I got it, boy. Can't get the bounty yet. All right, so discover Elsa's fate. That sounds like something from Frozen. Old threat. And speak to Quaid at the rover camp at Old Arcovia. Okie dokie. Let's do that. Okay, let's try to find Old Arcovia first. And then we'll do the old threat. Sorry about if I keep putting up the map. That's just my thing. Oh, wars. It should be fun. Boars, guys, not head on. If they charge you, oh damn, they're so strong. Those guys are strong too. Those kind of mobs, anyways. Boom. That's what's great about this about Demolitionist is the canister bomb. Hands down, one of my most favorite skills of that class. Nope, let's just smack those guys. Always go for the priest. If you're a melee player, always go for the priest first. If you're range and you don't have a kind of AoE, obviously go for the range. But the range in this game are the most... they're so annoying. But they have their utilities. See how they're gonna try to charge you? You don't want that happening. I mean, if you're playing softcore, whatever. I mean, if you die, you die. But hardcore, you don't want to die. It's part of the game, but you want to last as long as humanly possible. Especially the Ironhide ones. This one. Fudge, man. They are strong as like crazy. I try to go everywhere to kill as many mobs as possible. What I can do is I can take a whole bunch of mobs for next time and we can just level up a bit faster that way if you guys are like that. Much better. Let's go this way. Boom. Oh, definitely need another pistol at least, for God's sakes. But the drop rate when I play is so bad. It takes me so much time to get everything. It's stupid. So not bad. Mobs of level 23, we can pretty much get rid of fairly quickly. It's mostly the ones that are 24 plus that'll be a problem. as our DPS, single DPS, like as such, is not amazing. That's why I complained that I need to find something else. But I kid you not, level 40, this build will be amazing. With some gear, notwithstanding, you do need gear no matter what. But as I've always said, gear is good, but it's nothing without having a good player playing with it. If you're not a good player, the gear would only help you for so long. What did we get there? No, that's the blows. The blow. Let's try maybe. Nothing. Nope. I do pick all the yellows up, just to get some iron. It's important if you want to be buying potions. Let's get a whole bunch with us here. That helped a bit. Okay, this guy's gonna take some time. These guys are pretty strong. Don't get too close to them, unless you are really melee DPS. Then that's obviously fine. But you want to keep away from them as much as possible. Otherwise, you'll get owned like crazy. Okay, you die now. Try to go to every nook and cranny that this game has to offer you, because you'll be surprised. You will find some very good things here. Oh, let's go. Alright, is your family in there? Are you insane? You can't do this. Look, things are bad, but we can. You can't get. You're right. It's not. Devil's Crossing is safe, though. Join me there, yes. Okay, good. So we got another guy to our group. I don't read those anymore. I mean, I've read them all, but yeah. Let's try going a bit faster here. I'm sorry for the delay, guys. Oh. You know what I'm hoping for? Let's hope for some good gear to drop. Right? Okay. Well, that didn't do too much. Except the body. Okay, complete waste of time. Awesome. If I remember correctly, okay, I was going to put some points in Phantasmal Blade. Phantasmal Armor, not Blade. Demolitionist, I was going for full Vindictive Flame and Alzuin's Wrath and full Static Strike. These are fine for the moment. I might change the build, obviously, depending if I do get some really good gear later on. Oof. Fatal. Look what I said, huh? That was about, what, 10% of my health right there. 10%. Okay. We're not doing too bad. We could be doing better if we got more game. Yeah, I'll track him down. No problem. Give me your money. Huh, it didn't do anything. That's weird. Still crap, but it's fine. Alright, so we found Isaiah Redan. Are you insane? I'm here about your partner. Yo, whatever, man. Whatever gives me XP. Should be around here. Oh, I don't want that happening. Let's try to confuse these fuckers here. Zombies are the best, man. You just run around, just kite them. Level, yeah! Let's add distributor points right after we smash these guys. No, right after we take care of this. Whoop. See, I sometimes make the mistake of using the AoE on a single target, whereas I should be using the single used right here. Always go for Overseer first, and for zombies, always go for the mutated ones and rotting soldiers first. Unless there's a Fury, then you want to take care of the Fury. Get rid of these corruptions as well. They don't do damage, it's just they're really annoying. Alright, I did say I was gonna put some points in. Let us go for... What should we go for? Let's go for physique. It'll give us more health. And for demolitionist... let's go for two in here and another for Ulzwin's Wrath. Alright, so that takes care of that part. Oh! I didn't go into the cave entrance. Oh yeah, and Plague Walkers. If it's just regular zombies, but there's a Plague Walker, get the Plague Walker. Then go for those that do range. Obviously, because they're super annoying. Okay. Let's see how much. Oh, Ulzwin's Wrath does quite a bit damage. I will search it for you, no problem. Oh, Let's kill these fuckers. Alright, let us sell our crapos. Let's do this. Let's see if there's any good... of course there's no good guns. How about we go back down to the cave that was located right here? We didn't do that. Should be almost. Oh, actually, there's a cave here. Let's go on this one, this side. So in this area we will be needing dynamite because we need to clear one area. Oh, specters, my not so favorite things to deal with. So this guy does reflective damage as reflective. That's not cool. So let's just be careful how we do this.
That skill's not ready.
Okay, it's only when the reflect that's on. I'm straight up fade that. Okay, it's not on anymore. Paladin's studded helmet. Two less damage from 5 plus 5, 8 defense, 3% chance of 3 seconds of stun retaliation. That would be good. I am use. Let's use that. And let's say, so 6 armor. I said I was going to use this. I love the defense, but it's not offensive enough for me to use, so screw it. Oh, these guys, the super annoying, the haunted guys. You just have to be very careful with the haunted ones. This will just be less effective. See, this electrical damage, so he'll be have more resistance towards electrical damage. So let's try to smack him up here. Okay. That was good enough. Oh, sweet. So, mobs that do a certain kind of elemental damage won't be weak against that kind of damage. So don't forget, if you're, let's say, lightning-based damage, such as myself, if you're up against mobs that do lightning damage, that's why it's useful to have a second option as to do damage. If you're going to be doing crap damage, and if you have another weapon and it's the exact same thing, you're not really helping yourself. Alright. Mm-hmm. Boom, boom. Let's go see where this leads us. I wonder if it's on the other side. Oh, that's where we were before, so we'll just clear this crap here. Okay, oh. Huge tip, always be full on your potions. One of the first points I played hardcore, I'm like, oh, I'm invincible. This build is so good until you meet you come across a bunch of mobs like this, and then your health goes really down and you're like, where did my potions go? What I would like to see is when you have a debuff on you, it actually shows the debuff. So if I'm slowed, I'd like to see a debuff here saying, hey, you're slowed, do something about it. Okay. Let's see. So. I'm only losing 38 HP, but I am gaining more physique, cunning, resistance to cold, poison and acid resistance as well. So we will go with that. The more resistance that you have available to you, the better. Especially the last area of Don't kill me! Let's see how much damage he does like this. Okay. Well, the debuff shows sometimes, but not all the time. Come on, get off. The melee option is not really viable on this guy. Well, if you're ranged such as myself. Die! Okay, let's see what we have received here. It's two hands, so sucks. This is for occultist. Rare one hand. That's not good. 14 vitality damage plus 6 damage ethereals, 6 damage aether corruptions, 15 vitality. No, that doesn't work out for me. Nope. No, I don't want to go with a melee because I'm going to try sticking with what we have here. Maybe this is better. Absolutely not. Plus 2 fire. No. Still not good enough for me. I love these weapons, the sight, but they're always really weak. They never do enough damage. Look at that sucky damage, man. These hunted nobles, guys, get them. Don't even mess with them. Just kill them right away. Oh, and this guy too. Yeah. Spectral shield with potency. Oh, but you know that plus 2 to vindictive flame for the moment is just too useful. Wasn't there a... Snap. So it was productive, I would have to say. I got a level. I don't know. Why am I going that way? We did get a level. We got one replacement piece of gear, which is acceptable for the moment. And it's not amazing, but it'll do. Okay, good. Right. Oh, another bot. Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, this guy hits hard. Screw you. Electrify you. Yeah, nice. Why? Okay. No. This two hand and it still sucks. Plus 10. Nope. It is good if I was more melee Nightblade, especially at that level, that would have been great. But I'm not melee, we are ranged. A ranged Nightblade, well, ranged Nightblade. Saboteur. Saboteur. Perfect. Alright, so that's it for this area, guys. Next video, we'll try to get level 26 and try to collect some more dynamite and see what kind of quests we can complete. So thanks for watching, and I hope that you are following my series. If you haven't subscribed, it is Grim Dawn, and if you love it, make sure that you do subscribe. I will be posting daily videos of it every day until I die, which I hope is never. I'll see you guys next time.